In this video, I'm going to show you some of the best KDE shortcuts that can really improve your workflow. If you've been using KDE for a while, you might already know a few of them, but I'm sure you'll discover some new ones along the way. And who doesn't love finding a faster way to get things done? So, let's dive in. We will begin with shortcuts for desktop management. The first shortcut is Meta plus W. Pressing it opens the desktop overview where you can add new desktops or switch between them quickly. Next is Meta plus G. And just to clarify, the Meta or Super key is usually your Windows key, or the Command key if you're on a Mac. This shortcut displays all of your virtual desktops in a grid view, where you can easily switch between them or move windows around. Next, we have Meta plus C. This one shows your desktops in a 3D cube view. It looks pretty fun and visually appealing, but unlike the others, you'll need to enable it first. To do that, open System Settings, go to Window Management, then Desktop Effects, and scroll down until you find the cube effect. Once it's enabled, you can use this shortcut anytime. Another useful shortcut is for quickly switching between desktops. If you have multiple desktops open, you can jump to them directly using Ctrl plus F1, F2, F3, and so on. Each key corresponds to the desktop number. If you want to quickly open your pinned apps without moving your cursor, you can use Meta plus 1, 2, 3, and so on. For example, pressing Meta plus 1 will open the first app on your taskbar, Meta plus 2 the second, and so forth. If you've used Windows before, this will feel familiar because it works the exact same way there. If you have a lot of windows open and want to quickly see them all at once, you can press Ctrl plus F9. This will show all the windows from your current desktop. But if you want to see every window from all your desktops together, use Ctrl plus F10. That way, you'll get an overview of all the apps and programs you have open across multiple desktops. If you use touchpad gestures, you can switch between desktops by swiping left or right with three fingers. You probably already know that. But what if you also want to swipe up and down? Well, you can do that too. Just open System Settings, go to Window Management, and select Virtual Desktops. Here, you can increase the number of rows, which lets you move not only left and right, but also up and down between desktops. Once you have more than one row, you'll be able to swipe up and down with three fingers to switch between desktops as well. Now, let's look at some shortcuts that can make your work a little faster. For example, if you ever need to work with two folders, like moving files between them, there's a much easier way than opening multiple windows. Let's say I want to work with my wallpaper folder and another folder which is BG Images. Instead of manually navigating into each one, I can simply open a new tab in Dolphin. All you need to do is press Ctrl plus T and a new tab will open within the same window. This way, you can have each folder open in its own tab and easily move files between them. For instance, I can quickly copy my wallpapers into the BG Images folder without switching back and forth. The next shortcut is useful for checking if you've opened another instance of the app you're currently using. Sometimes we launch the same app twice and forget about it. For example, let's say I already have Firefox open. If I want to see whether I've opened Firefox in another window as well, I can simply press Ctrl plus F7. This will show all other Firefox windows across your desktops. The same works with Dolphin or any other app. Pressing Ctrl plus F7 will display all open windows of that application. Next, we have some shortcuts related to the terminal. The first one is Ctrl plus Alt plus T. This opens up the terminal, and since we use the terminal so often, this shortcut can definitely save you a few seconds. The nice part is that it works on almost every Linux distro. The second one is for when you forget to type sudo. If this happens to you and you find yourself holding down the left arrow key just to get back to the beginning of the line, there's a faster way. Simply press Ctrl plus A, and your cursor will instantly jump to the start of the line. Similarly, you can press Ctrl plus E to move your cursor straight to the end of the line. If you need to run multiple tasks in the terminal instead of opening several terminal windows, you can just use one terminal with split views. Click on the Split View button and you'll see all the options to open another split window. As you can see here, I now have three terminals inside a single window and I can use them all simultaneously. For example, in one split I can update my system, while in another I can work on a different task. And if you want to close your split terminal, you can simply use the shortcut Ctrl plus Shift plus W. If you ever want to save the output of your terminal as a PDF, you don't need to copy-paste anything. Just press Ctrl plus Shift plus P. A dialog will pop up. Here you'll need to give it a nice name, otherwise it won't let you save. You can also check out a few other options if you like, and then just hit Print. That's it. Your terminal output is saved as a PDF. Sometimes you might want to quickly open the folder you're working in from the terminal. In KDE, that's super easy. Just right-click and choose Open File Manager. And the cool part is, you can even open the same directory directly in another app, like Visual Studio Code. And here is the RPDF file that we just created. Another shortcut is for clearing the terminal. Normally, you might type clear and hit Enter, but there's a faster way. Just press Ctrl plus L and boom, your terminal is clean instantly. Now, let's talk about kRunner. You might already be using it, but maybe not to its full potential. To launch it, press Alt and Space. At first glance, it looks like just a search bar, but it can do way more than that. Of course, you can search for apps, files, and folders, but you can also type commands like power off to shut down or reboot to restart your computer without even touching the menu. It can even handle quick tasks for you, like currency conversions or unit conversions. For example, converting Fahrenheit to Celsius or checking how much USD is in euros, all without opening a browser. And if you're curious about everything it can do, just click the little question mark icon. It will show you the full list of features. So here's how the define and spell check features of kRunner work. If you want the meaning of a word, just type define followed by the word, and kRunner will almost instantly show you the definition of that word. Similarly, if you're unsure about the spelling of a word, just type spell and then your word. If it's wrong, kRunner will suggest the correct spelling for you right there. If you've been a Windows user for a long time, you probably have muscle memory for some of its shortcuts. The good news is, many of them also work here in KDE. For example, try Windows plus dot. It instantly opens the emoji picker so you can drop in your favorite emoji anywhere. Another useful one is Windows plus V. This opens the clipboard history, where you can see everything you've recently copied. From there, just click on any item and it'll be copied back to your clipboard, ready to paste. And here's another familiar one, Windows plus E, which opens the file manager just like it does on Windows. If you're missing Windows plus I for opening system settings, you can actually assign it yourself. Just head into System Settings, click on Keyboard, then Shortcuts. Find Settings under the Application section. Click on that little down arrow next to Tool. Click Add, press your desired shortcut, and don't forget to click Apply. In a similar way, you can set up almost all of your favorite shortcuts. Another one is Windows plus D. You might already know this, but if not, it instantly minimizes all your windows to show the desktop. Press it again, and everything pops right back. Last but not the least, we have some cool shortcuts to enhance your workflow. Ever lost your cursor and started wiggling your mouse like crazy just to spot it? In KDE, you don't have to. There's a shortcut to instantly bring your cursor right to the center of your screen. Just press Meta plus F6 and boom, your cursor is instantly centered. You can try this right now. And if this doesn't work, don't worry. Go to System Settings and navigate to Shortcuts and select Window Management. Here in the list, you'll find an option called Move Mouse to Center. In my case, it's by default assigned to Meta plus F6, but if it isn't for you, you can just manually add your own shortcut and start using it. Another quick way to find your cursor is by shaking your mouse rapidly or wiggling your finger on the touchpad. You might already know this, but if not, give it a try. Your cursor will temporarily grow bigger and bigger as you shake it. And if for some reason it doesn't work, just go to Settings, Accessibility, and under Shake Cursor, make sure this option is enabled. Normally, when you switch between virtual desktops, your apps stay only on the desktop where you open them. But sometimes you're working on something important, maybe a music player, chat app, or a reference document, and you want it to stay visible no matter which desktop you switch to. In KDE, that's easy. Just click the pin button in the title bar of the app you want to keep visible. Once pinned, the app will appear on all your virtual desktops. Another handy shortcut in KDE is for zooming into your screen. Sometimes you want to get a closer look at small details, maybe some tiny text, an image, or just to inspect pixels. Just press Meta plus equals and the screen will zoom in instantly. You can keep zooming in as much as you like to really get up close. When you want to zoom back out, just press Meta plus minus, and if you want to instantly return to the default view, press Meta plus zero. For some reason, if you ever want to temporarily make your windows translucent so you can see what's behind them, in KDE, you can do that too. By default, there isn't any shortcut assigned, but you can easily set one yourself. Just open your shortcut settings and under Window Management, look for the options called Increase Opacity and Decrease Opacity of Active Windows. If you can't spot them right away, you can simply type Opacity in the search bar and it will appear in the list. Once you find them, you can assign your own shortcut. For example, here, I am going to set mine to Meta plus Shift plus Down for decreasing the opacity, and Meta plus Shift plus Up for increasing it. Now, whenever I press these shortcuts, I can instantly adjust the transparency of my current window. You might be wondering, why would anyone need this? Well, it can be surprisingly handy. Imagine you're watching a tutorial video that shows some text or code you need to type out. Instead of constantly moving your eyes back and forth, you can make your editor window slightly transparent, place it right on top of the video, and type without breaking your flow. Without this trick, your eyes would be jumping around, which is tiring, but with a little transparency, it becomes way smoother and you will feel a little smarter. If you want to move your window, usually you have to go all the way to the title bar, click and hold, and then drag it around. But what if you could move it without even reaching the top bar? Like here, I'm dragging it directly from the middle of the window. If you already knew this, that's great. Let me know in the comments. But if not, here's how. Just press and hold the window's Meta key, then drag with your mouse from anywhere inside the window, and it will move instantly. If you want to resize a window, normally you have to carefully place your cursor right on the edge or corner of the window, and sometimes it just doesn't catch. The cursor slips past the edge, and it gets pretty frustrating. But what if you could resize a window without even reaching to the edge or corner? Well, you can! Just press and hold the super key, then right-click and drag. Even if your cursor isn't near the corner, you can still resize it smoothly, just like this. And remember, the Meta key is pressed and right-click to drag. If you want to open the application menu, normally you either press the Windows key or click on the menu icon. But there's a faster and cooler way. You can simply open it just by moving your cursor to the bottom right corner of your screen. Here's how to set it up. Press Alt plus space to launch kRunner, then search for Screen Edges and open the settings. Now you'll see all four corners of your screen where you can assign actions. For the bottom right corner, just select Application Launcher and hit Apply. And that's it. Now, whenever you swipe your cursor down to the bottom right corner, the app launcher will instantly pop up. In the same way, you can assign actions to all the other corners of your screen. For example, let's set one for the top right corner. I'm going to choose Present Windows from all desktops. Now, after hitting Apply, whenever I move my cursor to the top right corner, it will instantly show me every program I have open across all desktops. You can also fine-tune this feature, like adding a slight delay so it won't trigger accidentally if your cursor just brushes the corner. And that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you found it informative. If you want to explore more ways to customize your KDE desktop, check out this video right here. Thanks for watching.